Hey, what's up YouTube? Pallab here. We have the brand new CoolPad Cool One Dual SIM out here, and this is a full review video. We already did an unboxing and first look at this device, and you can check that out. That's a different video. In this one, we're gonna check out the performance, camera test, benchmarking and all those kind of cool stuff. So I'm just gonna quickly go through what's inside the box for those who haven't probably seen the unboxing video yet. So once you open the box, on top you get the CoolPad Cool One. We have the silver model, you also get it in gold model, and then some of the quick stuffs here on the back side as well. It's a dual SIM phone, and once you go further in the box, you get a free screen guard, you get some manuals, like that's the warranty card. You also get the quick start guide, and then you get the USB-C type cable, your SIM tray opener tool, and the 2 ampere wall charger. That is the phone. It's a beautiful phone, beautiful, hefty and rugged looking phone. It looks and feels great despite of having a 5.5 inch screen. It fits nicely into pocket, and 8.2 inch, so it's quite a fat phone, but that's also has to be with that 4000 mAh battery, which actually gives great battery life, which will come to in a while when we talk about the battery life. You get a quite fingerprint magnet front screen, 5.5 inch full HD screen, your typical other 8MP cameras, and dual SIM card slot. Mind you, this model does not support micro SD card slot, and you only get a 32GB version. That might be a disappointment for some. Actually, USB-C type port, your speakers, and some of the other buttons. This button feels great overall. It's all metal, feels very solid, but it's kind of heavy again due to that all metal construction and the bigger battery. It's near to about 170 odd grams. This is the USP of this device. At this price point, you do not get a dual camera setup. There's a 13MP dual autofocus camera with a dual LED flash plus your fingerprint. The CoolPad fingerprint sensors have been some of the best in the industry. This is no different. You have your noise cancelling mic and stuff. So overall, a very cool looking device. Another signature thing you would notice is that, see, Laiko inside. So CoolPad now is a Laiko company that you know. So the hardware is probably mostly CoolPad, but then the software is from Laiko, which is to say is a good amalgamation, I believe, because Laiko software overall, the UI is great, and it's based on Android 6.0. That also has to do with better cameras and probably even the audio options as well. And also, I think that Laiko genes also came into an absence of a micro SD card, I suppose. So overall, that's a 5.5 inch screen, full HD screen. It's a very crisp and bright screen and has a great viewing angle. Check out our color card, and you would clearly notice the difference between these two red palette and these two blue palette, which means that it kind of covers a very significant color gamut, significant enough to be able to differentiate between very closely placed color palettes. And also, see, the viewing angle is a very good, although not exquisite. Yeah. So overall, yeah, a very good display. Now, as I told you just now, that this one's powered by Android 6.0 and EUI on top. You see UI version 5.8 and Android 6.0. So out of 32GB, you get roughly about under 30GB, and that's all you have to deal with, because it does not actually support micro SD card, I told before. And as far as RAM is concerned, you see 851 MB RAM is taken by system, 162 is taken by MB taken by apps, and then 2.5 GB are available, which is a pretty good RAM management. Now let's talk about some of the apps. You get the typical Google Android apps, you get the in-house system tools like Clock and Gallery, Music, Play Store and whatnot, some of the other tools as well. And yeah, third party, not many. This is ours. Not many third party apps out there, but you get the Amazon shopping app, of course, because this one sells exclusively on Amazon. You also get the FM radio without having to use internet. So good thing. Let's quickly check out the USP of this device, and that's the camera. I probably have been clicking too many selfies because it opened up the front camera by default. Great front camera, good quality details, texture, and it's quite bright and it takes the exposure quite well, you can see, and does not lag at all. And what another thing I really like about the front camera here, Coolpad has really improved on the camera in this particular, in terms of UI and also in terms of performance, which we'll come back to in just a bit. So what I like about particularly in the front camera is that HDR mode. You generally do not get the HDR mode in the on the front camera. So you have an HDR mode and then also you have a beauty mode. In combination, they work really well in you know, smoothing out your texture and stuff. But if you do not want that, you can actually use the photo and then the video mode as well. Some of the other stuff like those, and then some of the filters as well. But what really shines here is the back camera. It's fast, you see? And also you have lots of mode like beauty mode, and you also have a pro mode where you can change or customize some of those stuff. You have video and then also a night mode that works fairly well. I have the classic mono version now. You see the video is 1080p, that's the max. And when I go to photo, you obviously have HDR and some of the shooting options. You also have the detailed settings menu here, 13MP max. So what's interesting here is this new mode that Coolpad calls SLR mode, which probably means is that it'll give you that SLR like you know, depth of field experience. And this is where the dual lens setup comes in, where one lens acts as a depth sensor and kind of tries to put the background out of focus and giving you that nice bokeh kind of a thing. Also has the filter the stuff. So yeah, nice looking UI, but the main thing is the image and video performance, which is great. And particularly the dual lens setup works really well. At this price point, you'd be really hard pressed to find a dual lens setup in another phone. This phone, you might think that they, you know, they might have adjusted in the quality because they had to give that dual lens setup or dual lens ecosystem in this price, but no. The dual lens, that at least that the lens could make the background out of focus very nicely. And the difference is actually noticeable. You can see in this set of pictures where without the bokeh, when we shot, then the background is clearly not as out of focus as probably a DSLR would make it. But when you use the dual lens setup and use that particular SLR mode, then you can see how cool the bokeh look like, and it's almost roundish. So although at a software level, obviously it cannot go to the hardware level of the DSLR, how much ever we talk about that thing, but it kind of emulates that effect really well. Overall, good quality details under enough light, and the beauty mode in particular works really well, including the one on the front camera. On the front camera, we took selfies under really low light, and that also came out pretty well. Overall, one of the best cameras at this price point, definitely. The speaker output is loud enough, as you can hear, but then it's, the bass is not very heavy, it's quite flat. Nice surround sound in the video, and also a good viewing angle so multiple people can watch the video at the same time. Overall, the UI is very snappy and we never felt any lag, even when we have a lot of apps in the background. You can see there are so many apps in the background, including the camera and a video, but it does not lag at all thanks to that MediaTek 1.8 GHz chipset and also up to 4GB RAM. You get it in two variants, 3GB and 4GB RAM. Now talking about the benchmark, well, it does not score to the top, but it scores about average, which is 73,000 in AnTuTu, and then right on top, actually more than the S6. That's really incredible in our Valomo Metal score, 2602. Again, similar story in our multi-core score, and then in Geekbench 4, 1467, when the S7 is 1808. Really commendable score, I would say. And then even in multi-core, it scores good, just above the average, and in compute score, above the average, good amount, right towards the top. So in most of the benchmark tests, in some it's above the average, but in some it's right towards the top. So one of the most powerful chipset at this price range. We also played some game on this device and it could play them without even breaking a sweat. There was absolutely no lag, very smooth. We tried NFS No Limit and we tried Modern Combat 5 and Godfire, our three signature test games. They are very demanding. This device could play them perfectly. And we tested the battery life with PCMark, and you can see it gives 10 hours, just over 10 hours of battery life with that 4000 mAh battery, which means that that's a screen on time, which is amazing. When you take the battery life, you know, overall, then 10 hours does not sound that good, but this is actually a screen on time. Screen on time of 10 hours is very, very good. That could actually take you the whole day plus some more. Some of the top devices out here, 13 hours. So see, not the highest device is not far ahead of 10 hours, so about 3 hours. Good thing, but 3 hours actually means here about half of the day. So this one will still take you more than one day. So then guys, now we're coming to the end of our review and the verdict time. Before that, let's talk about some pros and cons of this device. The pros are many. You have all metal body, all look quite heavy, but that also means it has a larger battery, 4000 mAh battery, which gives a very good battery life. Plus it's quite rugged and feels very premium in hand. Number two is that the camera is of great quality, and also the UI does not lag at all, and the benchmarks are really good. It's really powerful, does not lag at all. Some of the cons would be, for some, is mainly the absence of the micro SD card, and then the sound could have been slightly more bassy. I think that's about it. Another pro, I think one of the biggest pro, is that the price point. So despite of having a good dual lens setup, this one cost only starting 14,000, and that's amazing for a device at this range. If you like this video, please hit the like button, ask anything related to this, and we'll try to answer them all. And please subscribe to our channel and share this video to share the love. Thank you.